Hi everybody, thank you for watching and welcome to my presentation. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Tiasapani Putri. As seen on the screen, our topic today is non-medical community's perception of shop medicine for diseases, cough and colds. Today's topic is very interesting for those of you often buy or see people buying drug stalls. I have divided this presentation into 5 main parts consisting of introduction, discussion, conclusion, research methods, research results. My first point concerns the background or introduction. Research method. The method used is a qualitative research method. This method attempts to construct reality and understand its meaning. Thus, qualitative research usually pays great attention to process, event, and authentic. The method used was interviewing 3 non-medical people and 1 doctor. Research method. The method used is a qualitative research method. This method attempts to construct reality and understand its meaning. Thus, qualitative research usually pays great attention to process, event, and authentic. The method used was interviewing 3 non-medical people and 1 that is not necessarily due to disease, but always his psychosocial relevance. Meanwhile, illness behavior is very activity carried out by a sick person to explain their health condition and receive appropriate treatment. Self-medication is the use of drug for therapeutic purpose without professional advice or without a prescription. Self-medication includes obtaining medicine without a prescription, buying medicines on old prescription previously received, sharing medicine with relatives or members or on social circle, or using leftover medicines stored at home. The first point is research result. Conversation or respondent 1. According to a conversation with respondent 1, the respondent has only recently been self-medicating with shop medicine. But if it doesn't improve, he conversation or respondent 2. According to a conversation with respondent 2, the respondent had explained cough dizziness and cold. Respondents also self-medicated before going to the doctor, but respondent also used antibiotics, which are not free drugs that should be used. Conversation of respondent 3. Nah, this own interview with respondent 3, the respondent admitted that he rarely went to the doctor for dizziness, colds, and choose to self-medicate with several limited over-the-counter medicine. However, the respondent did not choose to go to the doctor and choose to continue self-medicating with this drug. This is what should be done all day, because if it does not improve, it is very that the pain is a symptom of a disease that requires further treatment from a doctor. Conversation of respondent 3. Nah, this own interview with respondent 3, the respondent admitted that he rarely went to the doctor for dizziness, colds, and choose to self-medicate with several limited over-the-counter medicine. However, the respondent did not choose to go to the doctor and choose to continue self-medicating with this drug. This is what should be done awful there because if it does not improve, it is very dead. The pain is a symptom of a disease that requires further treatment from a doctor. Conclusion. After condition interview with respondent and doctor, we were recourse persons, it was found that the over-the-counter and over-the-counter medicines have their own design, which has been clinically tested, so they are safe as long as they are used according to the instruction for use and do not have a maximum user yes limit for self medication. Then for the use of style medicines, medicines in the long term, if designers cough and cough don't get better, it's best not to do it because there is fear that define coughing a symptom of a more complex disease that requires medical treatment. Even how there are still non-medical people who we use this medicine as a long-term medicine, it never got better and didn't choose a doctor.
Okay guys, thank you so much for everything. Bye-bye.